I'm Joana Vicente, board member of ENFA. Today we are going to start a new project, Meet Our Members, which allow us to get to know our member organizations. So our first stop is in the UK with the Fibromyalgia Action UK. Our guest is Des Quinn, he is the president of the association. Hi Des, welcome and thank you for accepting our invitation. You can start.
It's my pleasure to take part. Thank you for having me. So, Fibromyalgia Action UK, we are the national charity within the UK. It's been in place since 1993, but I thought I'd start with our mission. And our mission, I think, along with other partners of ENFA, is about raising awareness, improving access to treatments, and providing support to those that are living with the condition. Improving research, improving access to treatments, it all comes from improving the awareness of our condition, because there are still plenty of doctors, patients, family members that know very little about it. And it's only when you come into direct contact with the condition that you perhaps start your path to learning more about it. So awareness is critical. Now, as I said, the charity has been about since about 1993. People gathered together, and there were a couple of support groups in the UK, and they decided in 1994 to create a registered charity. And from that, and we're lucky enough to still have one of the people that was there as a trustee, Janet Horton, who's seen the charity through all this time. But what does the charity do? We're all about encouraging support groups and interested parties to come together to help with that mission of ours, which is raising awareness. We've got groups around the UK, Ireland, and we've even helped start up groups and charities across the world, with the most recent one being a group within Gibraltar that we're trying to help get started. So it's very much, it doesn't matter where a patient is with fibromyalgia, they need support. And I think as any of our the members of ENFA would do, we will try and help people. And we're trying to also improve the quality of information, educate medical professionals, as well as patients and their family members about what the condition is and how it affects people. And we're a founding member of ENFA with a couple of our trustees having been on the committee or chair. So we really do believe in what ENFA stands for and what it does. Our current activities, well, we support over 150 support groups. We run two helplines, and one focuses on general information, the other deals with benefit inquiries and how people access welfare, etc. We have awareness campaigns, and we've got a couple of examples in a further slide that raise awareness in any way we possibly can. And when we're fundraising, we see that as an awareness opportunity. When we're talking or lobbying government, we see that as an awareness opportunity. It's central to everything we do. And this awareness allows us to promote research, and it allows us to encourage research to happen. And we've worked normally in a couple of different levels, and potentially it's just helping people access studies, whether someone's doing a PhD or whether there's a larger research activity going on. We'll share their surveys and get people from our community to participate. But we'll also participate as a stakeholder and help inform and design how the study goes forward. And we've been involved in quite a few within the UK. PacFind is one that's, I think it's over £1 million is the funding behind it, but there's quite a few studies that work that we hope benefit people within the UK, but also help inform what happens elsewhere. And it's very much the case that research doesn't have a geographical boundary. So any research that's done in the US, that's done in Canada, that's done in Israel, that's done in the UK, helps everybody else. And we try and put researchers in touch with each other and track what's going on within the UK, because often people were working in isolation And sometimes you can just be the connection that helps them get together, share expertise and push things forward. And we lobby and advance the fibromyalgia cause in any area that we can, whether that's working with trade unions, whether it's working with the devolved governments, the Westminster Parliament, anything that we can do to try and move our cause forward. Now, always when I'm doing a presentation like this, I like to bring back the individual faces of the condition. And we use case studies that reflect the full range of people that have our condition. It used to be the case that you needed to be a 40-year-old or 40-plus-year-old woman to perhaps get a diagnosis of fibromyalgia. Thankfully, things have moved on. And now people that were suffering in the same way, whether they would be male, whether they'd be younger, are now finding it easier to get a diagnosis and get support. But you can see from the case studies of Rachel and Kayla here, younger people that perhaps have got a longer journey ahead of them with this condition, that it can impact in many different ways. It can take away your career. It can impact on your further education, working at university, etc. It just makes perhaps what's already a challenging activity, like employment, like university, that much harder. And these are the people that we're trying to support. Now, how do we do awareness campaigns? A lot of them are on social media. Sometimes it will be direct to individuals, but these are examples of some of the campaigns that we've done previously on social media. The one towards the right, men get fibromyalgia, that was maybe, I think it's 2018, we started trying to put a focus to try and expand how our community is seen, the faces that represent it, and show more males that have it, because often males are not misrepresented, underrepresented, but they are a silent group that feel that they need to be represented better, just like younger people do. We need to show that there is a lot of variety within our community. And the picture on the right-hand side, picture of a crowd with various people coloured, purple or yellow. Some are diagnosed, some are undiagnosed, perhaps will achieve a diagnosis. We don't have that benefit of seeing somebody that has the condition. But if you had a group that large, with 1 in 20 people likely to have the condition, definitely people within a crowd at a bus station or a train station, there's going to be quite a few people there that have fibromyalgia. We're very much guided by volunteers. We're lucky though that we have more staff members within our office that help shape and keep the service that we provide on an even footing and consistently allow us to support people and keep our activities going. But without the volunteers, we wouldn't be running our helplines, we wouldn't be helping support groups, we wouldn't be participating at lobbying areas like the government, etc. Volunteers are central to how our charity is able to do what it needs to do. And we're still very much a small charity. But yeah, the work keeps on going. And without fundraising, and I'd just like to put in a couple of pictures here. These are what keep UK activities happening. These are what make what we do able to be done. Whether it's somebody, as the person on the left, strap themselves to a skydiver and jump out of a plane. Again, that's an awareness opportunity. That photo is used and brings more people aware of what our condition is, or whether it's people within the RAF that decide to walk from Goose Green to Port Stanley on the Falkland Islands in our t-shirts and do a 26 mile walk with full pack. Yeah, there's people all over the UK that have managed to raise that extra little bit of awareness and bring more people towards ourselves to find out more and then become involved themselves. And employers like the one on the right hand side that make us a charity of the year, it helps inform their staff, it helps inform people that are aware of the activities about the condition as well. And just to sum up, we're all about getting first inquiry packs little booklets that have information about the condition that are often the very first thing that people that are newly diagnosed be aware of what our condition entails. If we weren't here, if people at ENFA weren't there, then there would be people with fibromyalgia that would only have the information that a doctor or a medical professional provides. And I'm sure around Europe, just like in the UK, that it's that extra support from support groups, from people that have already walked this journey with this condition, that provides support, much needed support to those people, to our fellow sufferers, about what the condition entails and what hope there is by learning how to deal with it. Because it, without the patient, without ourselves, the support that we get from the medical professionals needs to improve, but it's really ourselves that need to help make our future better. So thank you. I really hope that this has given some little insight into what our charity does within the UK. And we look forward to helping ENFA move forward with our shared objective of raising awareness.
Thank you very much, Des. This was an excellent presentation. It was very nice to see, to have a very notional of what you do in the UK. This is very important for us, national organizations, ENFA, to know what each other do in the national level, so we can help each other and try and still raise that awareness and work what is needed to do, so we can help more people. And so thank you very much for all of your work, for everything. So if you live in the UK, you can contact the association, become a member. It's important for organizations to have members so we can do more. So you can find the links in the description. And thank you again, Des. Excellent work, and see you next time, everyone. Bye.
Thank you.
Bye.